Hello friends, welcome back. So in this session we will see the JDBC connection, and we will see how we can make the JDBC connection and how we can check the database information first. So first what we will do, we will connect through workbench to our database. Suppose we have created this JDBC demo database into our MySQL database, and we are going to connect to that database first. So after connecting this one, we will see what is the MySQL version of MySQL. So our MySQL version is 8.0.27. So to this database that is named JDBC demo, we have to connect our Java application, and we have to create the tables, we have to insert the data, so all that operations we have to do. So to do that one, first we need to make the connection with the, first we need to make the connection with this database. So how we can make the connection? To make the connection, we need one driver, we need the driver of MySQL. So this is the name of that MySQL driver, MySQL connector Java. Here will be the version, this X will be replaced with the version. So what is our current version? Our current version is 8.0.27, so it should be 8.0.27.jar. so this driver should be available into our project first. So we have to download that one from the Maven repository. So and after downloading from that one, we have to add into our project. So how we can make the connections for the driver, how we can establish the connection, connection with the database. So to establish the connection with the database, we need to use java.sql.connection class. So java.connection class can be used to make or interact with the data source, that is the database. So how we can make the connection using driver manager? Using driver manager we can get the connection. See, get connection. Driver manager has one static method that is called get connection, and that connection is taking three parameters of a string type. First one is the database URL, this one is the database URL, this is username, database username, and this is the password of a database. So this, using this one we are getting the connection, and that will return a connection. So this connection is pointing to database connection. So using this one we can get the connection. Here URL something looking like this, URL will be look like this. This is our URL, JDBC MySQL is the name of database where this database is present into your local host or whatever the machine address, server address you can give, whatever, wherever it is available. Currently that is on our local host, so we are giving local host, our local machine. This is the port number of server where the application is listening. This will be the name of database, and this will be the username, and this will be the password, username and password. So you have to give using this data data like MySQL or Oracle, you can give database type. This is the database type, host machine, this is a local host, application server port, this is 33606, database or data source name, this is a JDBC test. So it will be looking like this. MySQL is the database type is a MySQL, so this is the database type MySQL. Okay, local host is the host machine address, 33360 is the application port, JDBC test is the database name, root is the data source or database username, and root is also the password for that one. So so this will be the statements that you can use to connect to database. So let's see the code first. So this is our code to connect with the database. How we are making the connection? Driver manager dot get connection. As we have already discussed, we have to use driver manager. Driver manager class has one static method get connection that is accepting three parameter of a string: user URL of your database, username of database, and password of your database. And it will get the connection object. If that credential and that database is up, then it will definitely give. So here. So here, what is the URL? URL is JDBC MySQL localhost 3306 JDBC demo. This is our JDBC demo. JDBC demo, that is our database. This is our database name, JDBC demo. So this is our database name, and username is root and password is root. So that we are giving here, username and password, and we are getting the connection, MySQL connection. We are giving this connection reference variable name as a MySQL connection, and this MySQL connection we are getting here. After getting this connection, we are getting the metadata of that connection. Metadata means what is the name of the database, what is the version of the database, what is the driver name, what is the driver version. So n number of details, what details is there for your database. You can get the all that detail using this database metadata. So let's run this code and let's see whether this is connecting or not. So currently what we are getting, some exception. What is that exception? No suitable driver found, means drivers is missing. We have missed the first point. What is that one? We have to download the MySQL driver version. So what is the MySQL driver? So which driver? Driver for 8.0.27 MySQL. So how we will download that one? So we have to download the driver first, and that driver we have to add into our application, then only it will be accessible. So this is our driver, MySQL connector Java. If you search for MySQL connector Java, Maven dependency, and inside this Maven dependency, when you click on this link, you will get the list of available version. So which one is the current version that we are using? We are using 8.0.27. So 8.0.27, you just click on this 8.0.27 and just click on here jar 2.4 MB. Just download this one. So now this is downloaded. Okay, yes, so now this is downloaded. So we have to add that downloaded jar into our application. So how we will add that one? Just click on, right click on this JDBC demo project, go to property, and here go to Java build path, and Java build path go to library. Under this library you have to add external jar. External jar, go to your download, and under this download you have this driver. That driver you add and apply, and close. So now if you see, here referenced library, one option came. Under this referential library, what it is coming? MySQL connector Java. So this is the driver for MySQL. Okay, so now what we have to do, we have to run this code and we have to see whether we are able to connect or not. Okay, let's it starting. Yes, now we are getting success message, database connection successfully done. How it is coming? Because we are using one logger here, logger UTL. If you go to that logger UTL, here we are giving this logger file also. In under this logger file also, that log is available, or in the console we are getting this logger. Okay, so that is fine. So using this logger only, we are printing this message and we are getting this successful message here. So if I run this code again, you will see the message. Yes, So now here, if you see how many details we are getting database name. What is the database name? Database product name is MySQL. What is the database product version? 8.0.27 is the database product version. What is the driver name? MySQL connector J. This is the driver name. And what is the version of driver? Driver version is 8.0.27. Same. Whatever the database version, the same driver version we are using. Okay, so and we are printing one message, welcome to JDBC tutorial. Here is that one, this is welcome to JDBC tutorial. And after that one, what we are doing, we are printing one message, database connection successfully. Or else if it is not able to connect, then we are getting one exception, and that exception we are printing. Okay, so I am just running once more and you will see. Okay, yes, we are getting here. So this is the database connection, and this database connection is making, this is the detail for that one. Okay, and if we want to get some more information, like so many other information is also for also available for your database, so you can get all that information, all the informations you can get. Okay, why it is so much slow? Okay, see here, you are getting the so many details now. Drive database product name MySQL, database product version, this one, driver name, driver version, major version, minor version, default transaction isolation level 2. We will see what is the isolation level, transaction isolation level. So we will see all that one. So many details, extra number or characters, this one you can use, JDBC minimum version and maximum version, binary literal length, max schema name length, so that is different. Okay, so this is the detail of your database you can get. So currently we are getting only the four details, I think. So that details only we will get. Okay, so now those details only we will get, and we will run this once more. Yes, so this is the details of that one. And now what we have to populate the data. Which data we have to populate? This data. So currently if you see, yeah, we have to set up the table first. Which table? Coffee supplier, coffee inventory, merchant inventory. So we have to create these 5 tables along with this data. So that queries and that insert query for the tables that we have already did. So we will execute those queries one by one. So if you see currently in our database, there is no table. So what we have to do, we have to create the tables. So go to this statements and create table. So create table we have created. So create table, what it is doing, it is creating the table for supplier. This is the table of a supplier. This is the statement, create table if not exist supplier with this. These are the column, student ID, soup ID, soup name, street, column name, city. So these are the state or zip code. So this is the tables and that we have to create. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tables are there. So we have to execute those statement, and here we are using this statement. From this connection we are getting creating statement. In the next session we will see how many types of statements are there, what are those statements, and why they have given many types of statement, and what is the use of statement. In the next session we will see that one. So here just we are creating the tables only. So I am just running this program, and here we will get one message, tables are created. Yes, tables are created, which table? Supply table is created, coffee table is created, coffee inventory table is created, merch inventory table is created, and coffee house table is created. If you go to your database now and just you right click here and you refresh, when you refresh you will see here one arrow came before to the table menu, and here when you expand this one you will see five tables came now. Currently in this table there is no database, there is sorry no data. If you can execute select 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 star from coffee or supplier, from supplier we are not able to copy here, supplier, supplier. So you are not, so currently there is no data, there is no data, so it is not giving anything. Oh sorry, not to do. So currently there is no data, so it is not giving any record here, it's not giving any record here. So what we have to do now, we have to insert the data. Which data? These data in coffee table, in coffee table these five records, in this supply table these three record, in the coffee inventory these these many records, in the merch inventory these many records, and inside coffee house these many records. So that queries also we have already written, and we will just execute those and we will see whether the record is inserting or not. So here insert statements are there. So here so many again we are using here statements only. In the we will see this statement class in the next session, how we can create the statement, what is the use of these statements. Currently you just understood we have created some DML statements. These are the statement: insert into supplier, insert into supplier, insert into coffee, insert into coffee inventory, insert into merch inventory. So these are the statements that we have already created. So just we have to execute those and we will see whether the records are inserting or not. Now just run this one. Yes, so if you see from here three records inserted into supplier table, five record inserted into coffee table, six record inserted into coffee inventory table, 12 record inserted into merch inventory, and 14 record is inserted into coffee house table. So if you go to your workbench and if you execute this statement, now you will see the records is what happened. Select star from, it should come. Okay, so if we right click here and we will see select record. Yeah, now it is coming. See, select star from JDBC demo supplier. So these many record is coming now, five records in the coffee house. If you select, then you will see these many record in coffee. I think five records will be there. So these are the records it is inserting into your database. Yes, merch inventory. Yes, so these are the records it is inserted into your database using this statement. The same record is inserted. Okay, so this is how we can make the connection and how we can execute the queries. So now in the next session we will see the statements. Establishing connection, that is done, and now we will see the statement. What is statement? How we can create the statement? What is the use of statement? In the next session we will see all those. So I hope you like this session. Please subscribe my channel and we will see you in the next session. Till that, bye bye and thanks for watching.